Well, it's that time again, another massive unboxing. This time it's a Logitech G923, which is gonna be my first racing kit in, well, maybe like what, 10 years? So let's unbox it, shall we? Naturally, I'm very curious to see exactly how far these kind of racing peripherals have progressed, seeing how my last one was probably like a PS2 wheel or something. So let's just go straight into it, and oh boy, is there a lot of stuff already. Starting off, we have a power brick of some kind. We have, oh boy, haven't seen one of these in a long time. And of course your sticker, and I believe some ads. Lovely. And here is where the good stuff is. Starting with, oh boy, starting with this. Now this is a very special True Force Technology G923 racing wheel. And honestly, oh boy, it's heavy. It's definitely way heavier than I expected it to be. But quality wise, I mean, yeah, it's pretty top notch. The material on the wheel is pretty steady. Now, I can't really say much about how, you know, it compares to the feeling of a real car. I don't race those in real life, nor do I even have a driving license, because I'm one of those useless Gen Zers. So, you know, you just have to take my word for it when I say it's comfortable. But again, I'm no expert on the matter. And then you just simply have a USB Type-A connector to connect it to either your PC or console, because yes, this is console compatible as well. And you know what the great thing is? That you can get this in both Xbox and PlayStation flavors. And the second thing we have is, oh boy. I am probably the worst person to ask for opinions about how this is going to feel, seeing how, again, apart from maybe one or two times, I've never used pedals in a car in real life. But you know, these feel like rigid enough. You definitely have to apply quite a bit of force to get any of these down. So honestly, one thing I'm kind of curious about is how difficult this is going to be to use barefoot, because you know, I don't really walk around with shoes in the house. Okay, so this is how it works. Here is pretty much your hub for everything you may need. So over here, you plug in your pedals, and over here, if you have a gear stick, then it goes in there. And because pretty much everything goes through the wheel, all you have to do is attach one single USB Type-A port to your PC or console. So it's actually pretty efficient in saving you USB ports. And there we go. There is actually like quite a fair amount of room for cable management, so that's good. And there we go, that's actually all pretty nice. And we have the one little channel left if I ever wanted to, you know, really punish myself and go with a gear stick. So now we have pretty much two things left to do. Number one is the peel. So there we go. Wait, almost. Almost have it. There we go. Now, wasn't that satisfying? Oh, that was like barely in frame, wasn't it? Oops. And the second thing we have left to do is just, well, you know, connect it up and see if it works. Oh, we have lights. We have okay. Should I be worried? Did I break it already? Anyway, now that it's on, there's actually a fairly nice amount of resistance when you move the wheel left and right. It's actually pretty nice. So overall, I'm loving this thing so far. It is pretty great. And I love finally being able to have another proper racing experience in over 10 years. As someone who's a fan of racing games, I've always wanted to do something like this, but I wanted to get the right one. I wanted something that is as immersive as possible, but without going into the insane prices of someone like Thrustmaster, even though the name of that company alone kind of makes me want to buy their products. But regardless, without going too overboard on the price, then this is pretty much the best option there is. Granted, it's still very expensive, but hey, racing sim equipment doesn't come cheap. And if you want something that is still reasonable in that field, then this will probably be the best bet. If you want to help support this channel so we can make more awesome videos like this one in the future on more expensive products, then there's several ways you can do that. If you want to buy this thing yourself, then our Amazon associate links are going to be down in the video description below. If you use those, you don't pay anything extra, while we get some of the money, so it's a win-win. Down is also our merch store, and down there's also our Patreon. And if you give just one singular dollar a month, you help in a massive way while you get awesome perks as well. I'd also love to thank my existing patrons, Gavin Burns, Ryan, OKEB, Meg Sumner, Shane Allcroft, Lance B, Common Gauge Clothing, and Jesse Herbman. Thank you guys so, so much. Support truly goes a long way. Down there, you're also going to find our Discord server if you want to talk to me or others like this or whatever else really. Plus, down there's our social media links as well. But anyway, that's about it. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, then remember to subscribe, like, whatever, and I'll see you all in whatever I make next. Goodbye, everyone. Goodbye.